In the time since I uploaded my last video, I've added 4 new clubs to the game. In this video, I'm going to describe what makes these clubs unique, and how each of them will pose a different type of threat to the player. You might already be aware of the sports club, since they've been in the game for a few weeks. They have a more complex routine than any other club. They change their clothing in the locker room, do stretching exercises in the gym, jog on the running track, and swim in the pool. From a game design perspective, their purpose is to make sure that the gym, running track, and pool area will have witnesses present at various times of day, so that the player will have to be cautious when committing crimes in these areas. The drama club is more simple and straightforward. They start the day with a meeting in their club room, but they spend most of their time in the school gym rehearsing for an upcoming play. Similarly to the sports club, their purpose is to make sure that there are always eyes and ears in the gym, both in front of the stage and behind the stage. If the player needs to steal something from the backstage area of the gym, or commit murder in that general area, they'll have to avoid the drama club while doing so. The cooking club is a lot more unique. They prepare food in their clubroom and then walk through the school, visiting each student individually and offering them food. In the process of doing so, they will traverse almost everywhere and visit a wide number of different rooms, unlike the other clubs, who primarily stay in one location. If you're trying to get away with murdering someone, you will have to keep an eye out for any cooking club members who might walk in on you while trying to deliver food to the person you just killed. Technically, the gaming club has already been present in Yandere Simulator for a long time, but I've completely changed their clubroom and their routines, so now I consider them to be an entirely new club. They are currently addicted to an augmented reality game that involves walking around in the real world to hunt for virtual monsters. If you want to see what they're doing, you can take out your smartphone and activate AR mode. If you spot one of these monsters around school, you know exactly where the gaming club is heading next. I'm sure you realize how this factors into gameplay. Because the gaming club is always walking around school hunting for monsters, they are a potential threat if you're trying to get away with murder. If you don't want to risk being spotted by the gaming club, you should check for virtual monsters in the vicinity before you kill somebody. If you activate AR mode, you can actually destroy the virtual monster and make it respawn somewhere else in school. This guarantees that the gaming club will head in a different direction, so you'll have less witnesses to worry about. From a game design perspective, all of the characters added to the game over the past month are moving obstacles for the player to avoid. However, I should mention that any student can also be a useful tool to help the player get away with murder. If you receive a request from a student and complete a task for them, they will become your friend, and you'll be able to ask them for favors, such as distracting another student for you. But some tasks will also come with consequences that will affect the other students at school. For example, every day a group of girls will sunbathe at the school pool during lunchtime. On Thursday, Osana will join them. If you could somehow get all of those girls out of the pool area, then you'd be able to safely eliminate Osana without any witnesses. Allow me to demonstrate one possible way to do this. Gemma Taku, the leader of the gaming club, has a peculiar problem he wants to ask for your help with.
Why are you interrupting me?
It's really embarrassing to talk about this sort of thing, but I'm never gonna solve this problem on my own, so I'm just gonna come right out and say it. You know those 5 tan girls who are always on their phones? I wanna ask one of them out on a date. But they all seem to hate me. They avoid me and ignore me whenever I try to talk to them. If I did something wrong, I have no clue what it was. So I was wondering, could you maybe talk to those girls and ask them what they think of me? I just want to know if I can salvage things. Really? You'd help me with this? That's... thank you.
To complete Gemma's task, you'll have to talk to each of the 5 Tan girls and then report back to Gemma. The next day, Gemma will arrive at school with a completely different appearance. His transformation is so shocking that the 5 girls will spend lunchtime spying on him instead of sunbathing at the pool. This means that nobody else will be present at the pool with Osana, which provides the player with an opportunity to eliminate her without any witnesses. Well, actually, there will be one other obstacle to deal with, but I'll describe that in another video. Here's what the school's population currently looks like. These empty slots are reserved for future rivals. These empty slots will be occupied by students who don't belong to any clubs. And these empty slots represent the one club that has not yet been added to the game. Implementing this club will be my next priority. I hope you're going to enjoy what I have planned next. Thank you for following the development of Yandere Simulator.